Hi, my name is Ion. Since 2010, book scanners fascinate me. In 2011, I built a manual book scanner inspired by the designs of Daniel Reeds. This book scanner did not have the capability to turn the pages automatically. Since then, many different book scanner designs were created and shared on the internet. The community seems to adopt what I call standard models. So far, the standard models all were mechanically brilliant designs, but required the user to turn the pages manually. There were many experiments and prototypes in the community to try to automate the page turning, but none of these prototypes were developed to a point where they became the new standard. In 2012, I created this proof of concept of a page turn mechanism, and I uploaded a very shaky and noisy video of it online without any comments. Not long after, I gave up on the design because of a reoccurring problem that I call multi-page pickup error. Nonetheless, Hiroshi Yanagisawa found the video online and was intrigued by the mechanism. He built an automatic page turning book scanner based on the concept that I published a couple of years earlier, and he came up with an interesting solution to the multi-page pickup problem, which he called buckling motion. His design looks and works great. 2 years after he published videos of his invention online, I stumbled upon them and was fascinated. It was an awesome feeling to see my proof of concept not only implemented, but perfected and improved. Two other people built prototypes along the same concept, namely JCK57 from the DIY Book Scanner forum and a group of Spanish students. Maybe they saw my video, maybe they don't, I don't know. When I saw Hiroshi's design on YouTube, some things came to my mind that I could improve upon. I think he never intended his design to be buildable by someone with minimal tools. He also used off-the-shelf cameras with stock firmware and did not automate the downloading and post-processing of the images. Based on these impressions, I wrote down my goals for my next book scanner. They are easy buildable with minimal tools, complete automation of downloading and post-processing of images, detailed documentation of the design, and flexible and intuitive user interface. Obviously, page turning as well. After I set these goals, I sat down and started drawing my next book scanner. It took me 3 complete revisions of the drawings and the CAD models before I had something I was happy with. I used Autodesk Inventor to manage all the drawings and all the part lists for this complex project. With the final CAD drawings and a very detailed bill of materials, I went to the Foundation Wikimedia Deutschland. They agreed to pay for all the parts of the prototype build, and I am super thankful and grateful for this opportunity. I am also grateful for Seabase. I will use the resources and the workshop and the tools of Seabase to make this project happen. This will be my very first YouTube series. In the following episodes, I will bring you along in the workshop and show you all the steps that it takes to build the page turning book scanner LibreFlip. LibreFlip is the name of the project that I chose. Let me explain you the details of the drawings. The center part of the book scanner is the suction box. The suction box contains the cameras and has a tiny slit in the bottom through which air is sucked in the box. Behind the book holder, there is a small nozzle to give an impulse of air when the pages are standing vertical. On the right side of the book scanner, there is a small fan that I call the flutter fan, because Hiroshi called it that way. This machine has no counterweight. I will use rubber springs instead. The user interface is a touchscreen on the right side, through which all of the functions can be controlled. The automatic downloading and post-processing of the images is going to happen in the electronics compartment, right beneath the touchscreen. If you want to learn more about the project, a link to the project website is in the description down below. Please support the project by following it on social media. A link to the Facebook page and to the Twitter account is also in the description. New episodes will go online every Thursday. If you'd like to be notified when new episodes come out, please subscribe to my channel. I hope to see you soon. Thanks for watching.